Okay students, so now let us solve section formula in vector form. Section formula in vector form. Case 2 already I have solved. So now I am solving case 1. Clear? Let us choose two points P and Q. That means you have to write in theoretical form. Let P and Q be the two points, O be the origin. These all things you have to write before constructing the diagram. Clear? Let P and Q be the two points, O be the origin. OP is the position vector of point P, that is vector A. OQ be the position vector of point Q, that is vector B. Clear? And join the vector PQ. And join the vector PQ, where R be the internal point, where R be the internal point intersecting the vector PQ internally, where R be the point intersecting vector PQ internally in the ratio m is to n. This thing has to be written before after constructing this particular diagram. Clear? Let O be the origin, P and Q be the two points in the space, OP be the position vector of A, OQ be the position vector of Q, that is taken as vector OP equal to vector OP equal to vector A, vector OQ equal to vector B, that is nothing but position vector of point P, this is nothing but position vector of point Q, and position vector of point R is equal to vector R. Clear? From the diagram or from the figure, clear? From the above figure, you must remember one geometrical ratio. One geometrical ratio, that is RQ, vector RQ divided by vector PR equal to n by m. If you remember this, your theorem is over. I am telling, if you remember this, your theorem is over. If you don't remember this, you can't write your theorem. Why? Because if this ratio, this geometrical ratio, if you know, you can furtherly simplify. Further simplifying is very easy. Just you remember this thing with the construction. Clear? Because now RQ vector formula you know, that is position vector of the second point minus position vector of the first point. PR vector formula you already know, that is position vector of the second point minus position vector of the first point. That means what? Vector OQ minus vector OR divided by vector OR minus vector OP. Clear? That is will be equal to n by m. Now, what is vector OQ? Vector OQ is vector B. What is vector OR? Vector OR is small vector R. Again, vector OR is small vector R. Vector OP is small vector A. That will be equal to n by m. That will be equal to n by m. Now, cross multiply the terms. If you cross multiply the terms, m times of vector B minus m times of vector R divided by n times of vector R minus n times of vector A. Okay. So you have to cross multiply the terms and you have to write, that is vector MB, vector MB minus vector MR will be equal to vector NR minus vector NA. So now take the R terms on one side, the remaining terms on another side. R terms one side means this vector you have to take on LHS, minus NA vector on RHS. If you rearrange the terms, it will be M vector R plus n vector m vector r plus n vector r, that will be equal to m vector b plus n vector a by rearranging the terms. Clear? Now here the r vector is common. You take r vector as common, remaining term is m plus n, that will be equal to m vector b plus n vector a. Therefore vector r is equal to m vector b plus n vector a divided by m plus n So this is your case 1. Are you clear? So if you solve this much, your theorem is over of section formula dividing internally. Here note, if you want you can write here note if you want you can write if r is the midpoint, if r is the midpoint then vector r will be equal to vector b plus vector a divided by 2. Clear? Because here if r is the midpoint, ratio will be 1 by 1. So ratio will be 1 by 1, that means m value is 1, n value is 1. 1 plus 1 is 2, therefore vector b plus vector a divided by 2. This is the note. If r is the midpoint, if you solve this much, your section formula is over. Here the important thing is this one, vector r q divided by vector p r is equal to n by m. If you write this much or if you remember this much, the further things are very very simple, because formula of this you already know. That is what written here, and these things already you are written here. You just replace those terms, you just make a cross multiplication and rearrange the terms with the signs, correct signs. Therefore you can write this. So that's why here you can write the construction part also. Let P and Q be the two points in the space, R be the point which dividing a vector PQ internally, where vector OP is position vector of point P, vector OQ is position vector of point Q. That is written as OP equal to A, OQ equal to B, OR equal to R. Hence, from this, go on writing. Clear? So if you know this much, it's very well and good. Externally, I have already solved in the previous video. So now no problem. This is your section formula. You read it again and again. In the previous video while solving, I have written this as M by N. That was a small mistake. That video has been already deleted, no problem. Sometimes while writing, we make that type of mistakes, no problem. But anyways, now this is a very much clear and understanding. Okay. Hence it will be very simple theorem for you. So take it and practice.